Welcome guys. In this session, we are going to learn about NiFi registry. So Apache NiFi registry provides a way of versioning controlling. So let's say when you have multiple developers working on development in your environment, you want a kind of, you know, repository management system. So typically there are many other repository management systems like Git or SVN, which manages all the code repositories and all those stuff. So similar functionality you can achieve by using NiFi registry. So first thing which we need to do is go to NiFi registry website and download the software. So in the binary section, we can copy this link, and on our server we can press or we can type wget along with this URL to download the software. Okay, so step to download any software remains the same, so I'm not going to discuss the same thing again because we have already discussed this multiple times. Okay, I think there seems to be something wrong here. This is, I think, probably not the link which we wanted to copy, because yeah, it looks like this is some HTML page. Let me try to extract this and see if we are able to extract this. So first I'm going to just rename this from a very long name to a smaller name, and then I'll try to extract this. Okay, yeah, even I see the size of this software is very small, so I think this is not the correct file. Anyhow, let's try to extract this and then verify. Okay, yeah, I think this is not the correct one. So what we need to do is we need to go back to the website, and then we'll need to click on that link and we need to go inside and download the software. So this is not the software which we had to download. So click on this binary link and then you'll be redirected to a separate website. And now this is the first link, is the one which we need to copy, and then we can download it using wget. Okay, so as we see, downloading has started with the correct name, NiFi registry, along with the version name, number. So if we do ls-lrt, we can see the software. Now let's extract this software. So if you notice, the steps are going to be quite same of installing NiFi and NiFi registry, and both requires Java to be installed. Okay, so we have extracted it and we can see the extracted folder. Let's go inside this folder. So now if we do ls-lrt, we can see bin directory and conf directory. In the conf directory, we will have all the configuration files. So by default, Apache registry runs on port 18080. And if you want to make changes in the port, you can go inside conf directory and make changes in nifi-registry.properties file. So in my case, I'm going to make a change in the port to demonstrate you. By default, if you see, let me grep and let me show you what is the default port. So I'll run grep 80 in this file. So it will try to search 80 in this file. And as you can see, NiFi registry web HTTP port is set to 18080. So I'm going to open this using VI editor, and I'm going to change default port from 18080 to 18082. You can change it to any number you want, just make sure the port is available and it is not being used by any other application. Okay, now save and exit. Now I'm going to go to bin directory. And in the bin directory, if you do ls, you can see nifi-registry.shutility. Let me clear the screen first. Now I'm going to run NiFi registry, and we need to pass start keyword to start NiFi registry. So this is the way NiFi registry is going to be started, and this is going to be faster than running NiFi because this is very lightweight software. Now we can type NiFi registry.sh along with status to see whether this service has been started or not. As we can see, message showing that this service is successfully running. So yeah, we can go back to the NiFi URL and then we can make the changes in the port. So port on which we are running NiFi registry is 18082. Server IP remains the same because I have installed this software on the same server. And rather than NiFi, we need to type NiFi-registry. That is the URL for NiFi registry. So if you have installed it on a different server, you just make sure you type the correct IP address. And then this is the screen you are going to see when you log into NiFi registry for the first time. So guys, whatever steps you see I am following, that is well documented in NiFi registry documentation. So I am going to provide the same link in the resource section. It is always a good practice to follow the documentation whenever you are performing any activity for the first time. This will give you more in-depth knowledge about performing any action. So we have done the steps until here. Now we are going to create a bucket. So a bucket is a way of NiFi registry where it stores all the versioning related information of a flow file. So for that, click on settings and then click on new bucket, and then you can give it any bucket name. It can be any name. So I'm going to name it development bucket. Click on create. And as soon as we do that, we also get a success message saying that bucket has been added. So that's all we need to do in NiFi registry. Now in the NiFi section, we need to make this aware that we also have NiFi registry running. So the way to do that is on the top right side, click on this option and then go to controller settings. In the controller settings, go to registry clients. Click on register a new registry client option, and you can provide any name here for the registry client. Since it is a development environment, I'll probably name it development environment or development registry environment or just dev registry environment for short. And in the URL, provide the URL of the NiFi registry. So I'm going to copy paste from here. And in the description, you can provide any logical description. And this is optional. So if you do not provide any description, it is still going to work. You can just click on add. But usually it is always a good practice to provide description. So that's all we need to do here. Now we should be able to make use of NiFi registry. So I'm going to close this window. And now if you just look at NiFi screen, you do not see any changes. The only change you will see is that now when we right click on one of the process groups, you'll be seeing version option has been enabled. So let's right click on data enrichment example, which we had created in previous sessions. And if you see, version information has been added. So now we need to select start version control. So once you do start version control, this code is going to be synced with NiFi registry. And before we do, we also need to provide flow name, flow description, and also version comments. So this is typical what you do in any GitHub or any other SVN or any other, you know, code repository management system. So you always provide the name and also you provide commit comments. So I have provided flow name as data enrichment development, and in the flow description I'm going to write some logical description. It is always a good practice that you write in the version comments, you write all the changes which you are making in a process group, and the flow description can always describe the overall functionality which this process group is supposed to perform. So since this is a base load, probably I'll name it as base load. And then we are good to save it. So let's save this. And now you see there is a green tick mark which has appeared. So which means this process group has been synced with NiFi registry. Now when we go to NiFi registry, we'll be able to see a new commit changes in the bucket. So let's close this bucket settings. And let's go to home screen. So now you can see this is the bucket which we had created, and once you click on this, you can see there is a new change which has been logged, and this is the first version of this copy. As you can see, the version number is 1, and it is also going to tell you the date and time at which this version change has been done. So you can now continue making n number of changes in your process group, and you can keep on committing, and all those changes are going to get recorded in NiFi registry. So let's say a developer added few more processors in this process group. Okay, let's say some new error handling functionality has been implemented in this process group. So once I do that, I need to again go back to process group. So I'm going to select leave group and go back to the process group. And once we right click, we can see now it is showing a different symbol, which means that there are some local changes which have been done in this process group. Okay, so we are going to right click and we are going to see what is the changes which has been done. To do that, you can select version and then you can select show local changes. It is going to show you all the changes which you have done from your last commit. So whenever the last commit was done, post that any number of changes which you have made is going to be shown in the show local changes. Now I'm going to commit this local change, and you can provide version comments again. So since I added error handling functionality, I'm going to write added error handling functionalities in the flow file, or you can provide any comment. In the same comment you are going to see in NiFi registry in the buckets. Okay, now you can see a new version change has been logged. So new change has been logged with the version number 2, and it has been logged just now. And also you see the comments which we provided during the commit. Now let's say a few more functionalities has been added and the code has been being developed more. Then again you need to make another commit change, and then you can see, you know, the next commit change also in the NiFi registry. So I'm committing the changes which I have made. Now if you refresh, you can see version 3 has been created, and also you can see the comment which has been logged as part of version 3. Okay, now you see all those different versionings are available, and let's say you want to go back to any previous version. So the way to do that is you drag and drop process group in the open area of the canvas. And then when you do that, this time you are going to see one new option which is called import from registry. Previously when this NiFi was not connected to registry, you were not able to see this option. So now this new option has been enabled, and if I click on import, I can see the bucket name, and also I can see all the data which has been committed in that bucket. And I can see all the versions, and whatever version I want to see, I can select that version, and then I can import that version. And then that version of the process group is going to be added in the canvas. So now you see this is the previous version, and in this version you do not see any green tick, which means that a newer version of this process group is already available in the registry. And the same you can also verify from the comments when you hover over that. So guys, that's a way of handling NiFi versioning. So hope this session was useful, and now you know how multiple developers work on their own process groups and how they make versioning related changes. In next session we'll be discussing about how you can export and import any process group. So let's say you want to share this process group to someone over the internet, or you want to send it to someone who's having completely different environment which is not connected to NiFi registry. So we are going to discuss that in the next section. And also if you want to learn more, you can always go back to NiFi registry documentation. And if you see, we have followed exactly the same steps which were mentioned in the documentation. And for more details, you can read further about Apache NiFi registry user guide or admin guide. Thanks for watching. See you in the next lecture.